NXT TakeOver 36. We had six matches, one pre-show match, five regular matches on the card. I didn't catch the pre-show match, but here's the results. Ridge Holland defeated Trey Baxter in the pre-show. To open up the event, Cameron Grimes with Ted DiBiase defeated LA Knight by pinfall for the $1 million championship. If Grimes lost, DiBiase would have to become Knight's butler. Second match of the night, Raquel Gonzalez retained the NXT Women's Championship over Dakota Kai. And then the next match, Dragunov defeated Walter by submission for the NXT UK Championship. We got Kyle O'Reilly defeating Adam Cole 2-1 in the 2 out of 3 falls match. He had a traditional wrestling match, a street fight, and a steel cage. Kyle O'Reilly made Adam Cole tap out. And then the main event, Samoa Joe defeated Karrion Kross by pinfall to capture his third NXT championship. So that was the results there. Like I said, I didn't see the pre-show match between Ridge Holland and Trey Baxter. It says here it was only a minute 45. So, I mean, short match. I really enjoyed Cameron Grimes and LA Knight. In my opinion, this has been one of the most entertaining storylines of the entire year in all of wrestling, is Cameron Grimes and LA Knight. And that's just my personal opinion. Especially with, you know, Million Dollar Man being involved here. Like, this whole thing is just entertaining. It's really good stuff. In my opinion, it's very good usage of the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. Cameron Grimes as a character is just growing by leaps and bounds as each week goes by. And LA Knight is just a star. He's been a star for a long, long time. Both of these guys are going to come out of this smelling like roses, and that's a great thing when that happens. I wasn't a big fan of the Raquel Gonzalez and Dakota Kai match. It just didn't do it for me. I was also a little disappointed that Dakota Kai didn't, you know, capture the women's championship, but that's fine. Kaylee Ray showed up afterwards, though, so we might see some Kaylee Ray and Raquel Gonzalez stuff. By the way, even though I'm doing this on a Wednesday, I have not seen NXT from last night, so who knows? They probably already progressed things. I haven't watched it yet. Just for clarification, in case you guys are wondering. Here we go. Walter versus Dragunov for the NXT UK Championship. This, man, that was a wrestling match. That was so fun to watch. It says here that went 22 minutes. I couldn't have told you that while watching that. I couldn't have told you how long it was going. I was at the edge of my seat. It was really good. I lost track of time. A lot of emotions came out during that match. It made me very happy. That match alone right there was well worth watching the entire show. You know, the placement of the card on it being right there in the middle is, it's very debatable because, I mean, obviously you got the NXT championship, but this is the UK championship too. They're both, you know, the big things, but this wasn't a UK event, so that's why it wasn't the show closer. But if I had to compare this whole thing to anything, WrestleMania 25, they, you know, everyone had to follow Shawn Michaels versus Undertaker, right? On this card right here, you know, two more matches had to follow Walter and Dragunov. That's a hard thing to do, man. It's a hard thing to do. Depending on who you ask too. I mean, maybe they did. Maybe the two matches did deliver. I don't know. I was exhausted by the time this match was over. So, I mean, I was a little, especially going into that 2 out of 3 falls match. I was like, wow, I don't know, man. Maybe that's why they did the traditional wrestling match in that. But Kyle O'Reilly and Adam Cole, I mean, I'm not saying it was bad. I mean, it was fun to watch. It was definitely fun to watch. O'Reilly won the first fall. Cole won the street fight, and then O'Reilly won the steel cage match via submission. And speaking of Adam Cole real quick, we got a report here on PW Insider from Mike Johnson saying that a source close to the situation reached out to PWInsider.com after Mike Johnson's initial Adam Cole report went up and stated that Cole's contractual status with WWE, that his deal expires at the end of this week. Internally within WWE, Cole is considered done with the company unless he is signed to a new deal. Mike Johnson's earlier report featured a line that Cole is 100% free agent, but that was an error on his part, and it has been since removed from that report. For those asking if Adam Cole is popping up on AEW this week, which would be tonight or this Friday on Rampage, that can't happen. Because he can't even have contract discussions until after the end of this week. So Adam Cole and WWE could come to terms still. Or he could be on Dynamite or Rampage next week or at All Out. So there's that. All right, main event of NXT TakeOver. Samoa Joe, Karrion Kross. It was really cool. Samoa Joe, the NXT champion now. This, you know, with what they did with Kross on Raw the last couple weeks, last month or so, I think really put a hinder on everything going into this match with Samoa Joe. I think they exposed Kross in a very, very negative way, and it deflated what could have been a really solid, exciting contest between these two, Samoa Joe and Karrion Kross. And that's just my personal opinion there. There may be a lot of people out there may agree. I know there's a huge consensus agrees that Karrion Kross has not been booked well on Raw. I have not been overly impressed with what they have been doing with him on Raw, especially this last week. I heard the reasoning behind his entrance gear change with that mask and looking kind of like Demolition in a way. I get it too. You know, they want characters and personalities to be more marketable to go along with, you know, a line of toys and video games and different merchandise and stuff like that. But at the same time, it's just weird to see because there's a big clash between how NXT presented them and how WWE's main rosters presenting them. They say that NXT is a developmental brand, so you develop these characters, right? But when you bring them up to the main roster, you change them completely. What was the point of developing them in the first place if you're just going to change them? If it works, it works. Keep them the way that they are. If it doesn't work, you keep them in developmental and you just keep developing until you've got something you want that's over and you bring them up that way, right? Isn't that the definition of developmental, is to develop characters? And if it works, it works. If it doesn't, it doesn't. It's just my thoughts on that, man. Overall, though, NXT TakeOver 36, enjoyable show overall. There was really only one match on there that I wasn't crazy about. Not saying that it, you know, was the shits or anything, but, you know, every show has to have a weak link and every show has to have a strong point, right? You have to have a range. And in this event, in my opinion, the range starts with Raquel Gonzalez versus Dakota Kai as the weak part. And the strongest part is Dragunov versus Walter, in my opinion. I'm not trying to take away from anything, but that's just facts, right? Like, if you're in school, you're taking a class, there's the bell curve. Certain things screw it up, certain things. A bell curve could be screwed up by somebody doing really good. The bell curve isn't necessarily a negative connotation. It can have a negative result based off of an extremely superior result on one aspect of something. And the Walter Dragunov match was really good.